Not only do water molecules attract each other in cohesion, they are also attracted to other molecules that are also polar. This is known as adhesion. Cohesion and adhesion both play a crucial role in a water molecule's ability to perform the most extraordinary journey, rising up from the roots of a plant to reach the top of even the tallest trees on our planet. All plants need water in order to grow and reproduce. The process of water's movement from the soil through the roots up to the leaves where it evaporates into the atmosphere is called transpiration. Plants absorb water from the soil by a process called osmosis. In this process, water molecules move from the soil into the root cells via passive absorption. This occurs due to the difference in solute concentrations between the inside of the root cells and the outside soil solution. The water molecules move from the area of higher water potential to the area of lower water potential across a semi-permeable membrane, which is the cell's wall. From the root cells, water is then transported into the xylem vessels, which act as a vascular system for the plant. It is within these xylem vessels where the water molecule makes its remarkable journey, defying gravity and rising upwards towards the plant's foliage. Adhesion is what allows the water molecule to stick to the xylem cells, as these cells are also polar. But because the adhesion to the xylem walls is greater than the cohesive forces between water molecules, the water rises upwards. This phenomenon is better known as capillary action. However, it is not capillary action alone that allows water to move through plants. In the process of transpiration, a constant balance is maintained between the water going into the plant and water lost through evaporation. When water evaporates through the leaves, it creates a water deficit, which leads to a negative pressure, creating a pull within the xylem vessels. This differential pressure helps with water circulation, which allows for nutrients to be distributed where they are needed throughout the plant. In fact, only a small percentage of water itself is absorbed during transpiration. Instead, it is the dissolved nutrients carried in the water that are crucial for maintaining life in plants. And water's ability to dissolve these nutrients introduces us to another one of its astounding properties and explains why water is often referred to as the universal solvent.